before, I need to see a visual of what's happening with the valve. I've got gauges on the upstream side and on the downstream side. The valve that I just showed you was the pressure reducing valve. Just by turning this, I am able to adjust the pressures. See how much? That's a quarter turn. I just went up 10 psi on the inlet.
That was
here.
A quarter turn.
That's a quarter turn.
Wow.
I'm doing this by hand. That's how sensitive this is. Now this system is putting out 50 psi, about 100 gallons a minute.
So if somebody went in there and turned it like 15 turns, you're gonna bring a main out of the ground.
You can easily do that.
Easily.
Easily do that. Just by this simple adjustment of this screw. Now, that's a pressure reducing valve. So the idea is I have 50 psi upstream, my customers downstream only want to have 25. Alright, so that's how I've handled that, just by this one pressure reducing valve.
So Kevin, the question I have, if I'm going to take a tank out of service to get painted, rehabilitated, this is the valve, this is the application where that tank would be, I would basically install this valve, correct?
Correct. What you want to, this is a pressure reducing valve. So you're trying to just protect the people downstream.
Correct.
All right, you want to knock their pressure down. You're coming off of a high pressure zone, and you have some older infrastructure. You've got people that don't have the newest of ductile iron rated pipe. That happens a lot when water companies take on another utility that wasn't well maintained. The most common time to get a line break is in the middle of the night, and the reason being.
Because the system's the highest pressure because the tank's full.
The tank's full. And during the day, it's high demand. So people are always turning on the faucets. They're running their washing machines. They're flushing the toilets. So pressure's down because there's so much demand being drawn on the system. Well, at night, everyone goes to bed. Basically, everyone shuts off the valve. So now you have all this pressure building up. You have some old infrastructure, some old pipe. All that stuff starts leaking and collapsing. Because it went from 50 psi during the day, and it crept up to 75 at night. And that's enough to stress the pipe and take it apart. Now, there's one thing, when that happens on these pipe breaks, you have a pressure reducing valve, and that'll knock down the pressure downstream. But you need to think about the people upstream. Say I have a line break, and that's downstream. What about the people upstream? What if I have a hospital, a school, a community center? I can't afford to lose pressure in that area. So what do I need to do? I just need to set up another simple pilot system. Okay? So right now we have about 51 psi upstream.
Yep.
Our downstream pressure is about 25. So here, my little pilot right now, my pressure reducing pilot, just knocked the pressure down in half. Okay? Now, if I don't have this device here, I hit a line break, that's going to drop to zero, or we have nothing left. By putting this pilot in here, I'm going to mimic a line break. I'm simply going to open up this valve, and we want to look at the upstream side. So boom, I just had a line break.
And the pressure fluctuated maybe a half a pound.
Yep. There's our downstream that just blew out. Okay, so now we have nothing down here. But look at this little pilot. I'm still maintaining 50 psi upstream. If you don't have this loop in here, I'm blowing out water, and you're now you have a gusher. So your sinkhole just got bigger, and you lost all of your product. And all these people upstream, they're calling your utility right now, saying what happened. This simple pipe mount. There's a couple braided stainless steel tubes, and another pilot. This system, no matter what size valve it is, it's a few hundred dollars. You lost a few hundred dollars per second if you didn't have this. That's something, this whole concept is entirely overlooked by the whole engineering community.
It is. It's this back pressure sustaining valves are really misunderstood as what I've seen in my lifetime dealing with folks in the industry.
Yep, for a few hundred dollars, you just saved yourself a lot of headache.
Well, thank you, Kevin. I appreciate it.
Thank you.